بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. عندي أبيات جميلة فاكتبوها فائدة. العلم صيد والكتابة قيده. العلم صيد والكتابة قيده. العلم صيد والكتابة قيده. قيد صيودك بالحبال الواثقة. قيد صيودك بالحبال الواثقة. قيد صيودك بالحبال الواثقة. فمن الحماقة أن تصيد غزالة. فمن الحماقة أن تصيد غزالة وتتركها بين الخلائق طالقا. وتتركها بين الخلائق طالقة. سأعيدها من البداية. العلم صيد والكتابة قيده. قيد صيودك بالحبال الواثقة. فمن الحماقة أن تصيد غزالة وتتركها بين الخلائق طالقا. هذا كان يحث علينا هذا لما كنا في اليمن. وهو is encouragement to write down. العلم صيد والكتابة قيده. Knowledge is a prey, something that you hunt for. تصطادُهُ. Knowledge is something that you have to chase, you have to work for it. So writing it down, this is what catches your prey. When you write it down, that's what catches it. نعم. قيد صيودك بالحبال الواثقة. Right, grab your prey with a rope that's guaranteed to keep it together. نعم. فمن الحماقة, that which is ridiculous and unthoughtful, نعم, is that you hunt down a deer. When you catch the deer, then you just leave it free to go and no, it's free to rain and run away after you worked hard to catch it. نعم. فالذي يطلب العلم يجلس في الدرس ولا يكتبها كأنه استعد غزالا أو صيدا أو حوتا أو يعني شيء كبير. Like he came in the class, he caught the biggest of صيد, the biggest of prey, a deer, a shark, a whale. But then after the class, he just lets it go. Because it's not going to stay. فقالوا من هذا كيف من حفظ الحفظ قره. نعم الحفظ, نعم الكتابة قرة والحفظ فرة. نعم يعني ما هكذا. لا سأزيد. ما كتب قرة وما حفظ فرة. هكذا يقال. ما كتب قرة. That which is written down stays. ما كتب قرة. ما حفظ فرة. That which is memorized is just going to go away. It's going to leave you. You have to write it down. You can't rely on your memory. Barakallahu feekum. طيب عندي سؤال. وسألناكم من قبل. We asked this before. After you say Allahu Akbar in the salah, what's the first thing that you say after Allahu Akbar? What's the first thing? نعم يا بابلا. دعاء الاستفتاح. نعم.
فَهَذَا مِنْ بَابِ تَنَوَّعَ الْإِبَادَاتِ What I'm mentioning now. From when you worship, that you one time you say this dua, next time you say that dua, next time you say that dua, and next time you say that dua. هَذِي يَعِينُ عَلَى الْخُشُوعِ There's asbab الَّذِي يُعِينَ الْخُشُوعِ الْخُشُوعِ مَا مَعْنَى الْخُشُوعِ لُغَةً خُضُوعِ That you lower yourself. نعم وخشعت الأصوات للرحمن فلا تسمع إلا همسة يوم القيامة خشعت الأصوات All the voices are going to be low. خشعت أبصارهم يوم القيامة Everybody's just going to be able to look down. You're not from the شدة الخوف. You can't look up. خشعت أبصارهم The eyes is going to be down. فخشع خشع means خضوع خشوع بمعنى خضوع I mean salawa. But that's lugatan. In the salah, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ What is matlub? What is required? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ They're successful, the believers. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ Those who have khushu' in their salah. What is required from us in the salah as far as khushu'? Does Allah want us to cry? Is that what's required? No, that's not what khushu. That's natija khushu. That's the result of having khushu. What is the point in khushu? Huwa? Na'am? Tuma'nina. Walakin, ya ikhwa, indama naqul hadhi al-kalimat tuma'nina, ashanin عند أخينا طمأنينة قد يكون له معنى وهذا له معنى وهذا له معنى الطمأنينة هي كلمة عامة نعم هو حضور القلب حضور البال يعني أنت تدري أين أنت it's that you're attentive نعم حضور القلب you're attentive you're paying attention والسكون الجوارح and that your body is still You're not scratching your head, you're not fixing your thawb, you're not fixing your clothing, you're not scratching and itching and moving. Now if we looked at you, if you wasn't facing the Qibla, we wouldn't know what you was doing. Like this, you up there like this, you might have done something and pray like this. Are you praying? Sunday? Nah. So this is what khushu' is. Khushu' is what? Hudur al-qalb. Nah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ أَوْ أَلْقَ السَّمْعَ وَهُوَ شَهِيدٌ طيب ننظر في أي سورة هذه الآية أم إسماعيل إِنَّ فِي ذَٰلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ Verily in the Quran نعم is a reminder for those that have a heart نعم أحسنت الله يزيدك من فضله سورة قاف أو ألقى السمع or he listens closely وهو شهيد ما معنى شهيد ما شاء الله ما اسمك يا خانة ما شاء الله محمد تمام أحسنت شهيد بمعنى حضرة يعني قلبه حاضر ألقى السمع وهو شهيد الذهن ذهنه موجود نعم هذا خشوع هذا خشوع قلبك حاضر that your attentiveness is there and you also have sakina what is it that helps you have خشوع in the salah no he said that you understand Arabic كم من عربي لا يخشع في صلاته How many people understand Arabic and they don't yaksha fi salah? Na'am. That helps. Na'am, but that's not the major. Na'am. One of them, before we get back to our topic, before I forget, one of them, kana Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fi hadith an Ammar ibn Yasir, al-Razin qali, ya Aba Yaqdan, رأيتك تجاوزت وأسرعت في الصلاة. I see that you rushed when you made صلاة. قال هل تنقصت في حدودها؟ قال لا. He said, did you see, even though I rushed, did you see that I left something out? I was deficient in anything in the salah? Qala la. Qala sabaqtu biha sahwati shaytan. Min sahw. Sabaqtu biha. Sara'tu biha sahwati shaytan. I rushed and was trying to beat shaytan before he comes to me with anything. Arka. I make rukua. Then when I'm in rukua, I come up before shaytan comes to me. I say, Samillah no namida. When I say that, Allahu Akbar. Go to Masujud. Before shaytan comes to me, Allahu Akbar. Come on. Sabaqtu bihi sahwati shaytan. I rushed, I preceded it before sahwa means a saw, like sujud al sahw. But from the waswasa and the forgetfulness of shaytan came to me. Qala sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, inna al-rajul la yansarif min salatihi la yuktab minha lahu illa ushruha aw tus'uha aw thumnuha aw sub'uha aw sudusuha aw khumsuha aw thuluthuha aw nisfuha. Ya subhanallah ka'anna qad shahidna hadha ya akhwan. Na'am. Alam nashhadu ala anfusina. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a man, he says, salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, he leaves the salah. It's not written for him, for his salah, except a ninth of the salah, or an eighth of it, or a seventh of it, or a sixth of it, or a fifth of it, or a quarter of it, or a third of it, or a half of it. An eighth of it, and imagine somebody makes four raka'ahs, he gets a half. Half a raka'ah, that's all the credit you get. One eighth of the salah. You made four raka'ahs, we give you half. The other half is not written down. You wasn't making salah. You was not making salah. Nah. And that's khatir, that's dangerous, because you're making salah every day. Nah. Or a quarter of it, you make four raka'ahs, you get credit for one. Or half of it, you make four raka'ahs, you get credit for two. Two raka'ahs. Nobody wants that. Man. So what is the help? What is one thing to help you in the khushu'? Keep your salah short. Because you'll find sometimes that you forget when you tawwil. When you go down and say, SubhanAllah, SubhanAllah, oh Allah, ya Allah, oh Allah. Then you go, whoa, Allahu Akbar. I don't know where I'm at. Am I, is the first sujood? Is it the second sujood? Because you tawwil. Na'am. So you have to build in your khushu'ah. Habu tatqawwa in your khushu'ah. Fa you start off slowly, start off a little bit. Na'am. Fa hadha kana ahyanan da'abu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what the Prophet used to do. Qalat Aisha radiallahu anhu, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kan yusalli raka'atain lil fajr, any qabl al-fajr. Wa aqul hal qara'a fihima بفاتحة الكتاب. Nah. The Prophet used to pray two raka'ahs before Fajr, and I used to say to myself, did he read Fatiha? And it was so quick. Nah, it was so quick. Did he read Fatiha? Nah. Wa yawm al-fath fakhita bint Abi Talib wa ukhtu Ali radiyallahu anha fakhita قال صلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثمانية ركعات من الضحى أسرع ما رأيته يصلي. It's the fastest I ever seen him pray. So praying fast is okay as long as it's in حدود. ما دام هو في الحدود أنت تركع تماما تقوم تماما تسجد تماما وتفعل كل شيء تماما. As long as you do everything correctly, there's nothing wrong with being short in the salah. Not that it's fast, but it's short. Mujiz. It's short. Naam. Your ruku' is short. Time. How many times do you have to say Subhana Rabbi al-Azim in the ruku'? The least amount. The least amount.
One.
One time. Wa as-sahih annahu wajib. There's an ikhtilaf that is wajib or mustahab. Lakin lazamahu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَمْرَ بِهِ فَيَدُلُ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ وَاجِبٌ. It's wajib in the salah. Nah. But one time is yakfi. One time. Nah. You can say it 3 times, you can say it 5 times, you can say it as many times as you want. One is necessary. Same thing with what? Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Tayyip, now let's go back to our dua al-istiftah. What's another thing to help you in the khushu'? That you tatanawwa. You say different du'as in different areas. It's like, for lack of a better word, ka'annak, you're mastering the salah. Anta tutqin salah. Hadha mas'ala salah. Ka'annak taqul, yani ana al-an 40 sana, 50 sana. Kuntu usalli 50 sana. Kuntu usalli 40 sana. Wa ma zat atakhabbat fi. I've been praying 40 years and I'm still stumbling in my salah. I'm still forgetting. I haven't got this thing down yet. قال الآن من اليوم نحاول نتقن هذا الشيء. We're going to try to perfect this thing. Well, we're going to start off making it small. Now we're going to start making it small. Just a little bit. صلاه الضحى. Even في قيام الليل. قيام الليل فيها بركة خير كثير. To stand up at night. ولكن هو في مشقة. نعم. أنا من الأولين الذي يجد فيه مشقة. نعم. And it is difficulty. But how should you start? You're going to start like 3 o'clock in the morning and you're going to pray all the way to Fajr and you know you have to go to work and you're not going to be able to handle it. Start off after Isha. Just do something. And when you start off Isha, you're not going to read a lot. Just read a little bit. وأحسن من الصفر. ارحم نفسك. And you're going to تتقوى. You're going to get stronger. You're going to get better. قصدك ليس هذه الليلة. You're not just trying to do it tonight. You're trying to do something فيها استمرار. You're going to try to do it and you're going to keep on doing it and keep on doing it and keep on doing it and keep on إلى أن تموت. نعم. فهذا لابد من النية. So from the things that you do to aid your khushu' is what? That you say one du'a, one salah. Another du'a, you say another salah, you say another thing. Or one day, you might do it. Right? For the du'a, al-istiftah. ماذا تقولون? What do you say? وجهت وجهي للذي فطر السماوات والأرض. هذا du'a طويل. هذا واحد. So, maybe you might do that when you have time to do that. Understand what I'm saying? Maybe you might come at Dhuhr and you start that one and you don't know it, they call in the Iqamah and you didn't finish your salah. So the Prophet used to do that for Qiyam al-Layl. So you have to look. When do I have time to say this? When do I have time to say that? When is it convenient to say that? That's one. That's number two. Allahu Akbar Kabira. This is what you teach your children. This one is easy. Teach your family. Make sure they know it. I'm saying teach your family. These days, our wives know more than us. Maybe we have to go to them and ask them to teach us a couple of du'as. Nah. Subhanakallah, nah. But let me mention this one that Ismail said. Allahu Akbar Kabira. Alhamdulillah Kathira. Wa Subhanallahi Bukratan Wasila. I mean, you say Allahu Akbar. The first thing you're going to do after you say Allahu Akbar, and yajid as-sakina. You're not going to say Allahu Akbar Kabir, Alhamdulillah Kathir, Subhanallah. No, you're going to tajid sakina. You're going to be still, motionless, qa'im. Hada ibadah azima. Standing before Allah is ibadah azima. Ashil ahirin. Al-Muhim, ibadah azima, al-qiyam. Na'am. Qumu lillahi qanitin. Na'am. Stand before Allah in obedience. Na'am. So you're going to stand before Allah. Na'am. And in this society, they have a moment of silence where they stand in silence. Na'am. But they don't stand before Allah. You know, if somebody died, they have a moment of silence for the one that died. You don't stand for Allah? When you stand for Allah? In silence and attentiveness. For Islam, as-sumut, man la ta'budu Allah bis-sumut. There's no such thing like, I'm not talking today. Hadha laysa min dinina. An yata'abbad Allah bi-tark al-ta'am, na'am. Wa tark al-shurab, na'am. Amma tark al-kalam, هذا ليس من منهجنا، هذا ليس من ديننا. نعم. فلا بد وأنت في الصلاة even وإن كان سرا، even if the salah is quiet, you can't be solid, you can't pray like that in your head. Allahu Akbar. No, you have to move your lips. You have to actually move your lips. You have to read. You have to read, but it's a reading that's silent. Can't be this way. Next one is on Umar. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika wa tabaraka smuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruk ma ma'na jadduk. Tabaraka smuk. Your name is tabarak, blessed. Wa ta'ala jadduk. And it's shaha, your jad, yani sha'nuk, azamatuk. Ta'ala is high. Na'am. There's something that comes more authentic than everything that you mentioned. اللهم باعد بيني وبين خطاياي كما باعدت بين المشرق والمغرب اللهم نقني من خطاياي كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اللهم اغسلني من خطاياي بالثلج والماء والبرد. Also what? الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. So one day you might do that, another day you might do that. You just might just switch it up. But you, when you say Allahu Akbar, this is when you're going to think. This is going to help you keep on focus on the salah. Because you're going to say Allahu Akbar, and you're going to, I have hadith Umar, I have hadith Abi Huraira. Inshallah. Let me take this one here. And your mind is just on the salah. Then after you say that, what do you say after you say Dua al-Istiftah? In the salah, what do you say after that? A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajeem. Then you say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And you read Fatiha. After Fatiha, you read Ma tayassara lak min al-Quran. You read that which is easy for you in the Quran. That when you get in ruku, first of all, after Fatiha, you have a choice according to what you memorize. According to what you memorize. Tayyib, in this su'al, somebody memorize وَالسَّمَاءِ وَالطَّارِقِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الطَّارِقِ النَّجْمُ الثَّاقِبُ إِن كُلُّ نَفْسٍ لَمَّا عَلَيْهَا حَافِظٌ. He reached here, he's still memorizing the surah. He still has something in it. Can he just read this part? This is all he memorized. Can he just read this part? It's just four ayahs. The surah has like 11 ayahs. Can he read that part?
No.
Just like Baqarah. If he's memorizing Baqarah and he memorized 100 ayahs, can he read from that 100? Nah, make away from the hadith. And if you memorize on it, you write from that. Faqra' ma tayassar. Even that which makes it easy. So this all helps you in your salah. So reading new surahs, now it's going to help you. It's going to you're going to find in your salah, nashat. You're going to find in your salah, nashat. So when you get in ruku', there's a number of things that you can say. We'll take that on another class. And then when you get in sujood, there's a number of things that you can say. And we mentioned before, at-tahiyya, at-tashahud. It's different of the shahad. You have the shahad of Ibn Mas'ud, the shahad of Ibn Abbas, and the shahad of Umar. All of these help in what? Al-khushu'. For all of you, all of you, كل واحد يقرأ قرآن. هذا شأن. كل واحد يقرأ قرآن. Try to make it something that's in your daily program. How much time does it take to read Quran? Kullun bihasabi. It doesn't take it take 10 minutes is khair, mashallah. 10 minutes is khair kathir. Naam. Lil qira'a wa lil tadabbur. Naam. Even if you read the same page over, even if you took it to review some surahs, sometimes you might review a surah just to skim through it. Naam. To re-familiarize yourself with it. And sometimes you might go through it to review it to actually get it perfect this time. But you look at the time that you have, according to what you have. Mother and Dick after Fajr, how's your time after Fajr? It's between you and Allah, you know what you have. How's your time after Fajr? How's your time after Dhuhr? How's your time between Maghrib and Isha? How's your time after Isha? Take a little bit of time. طيب عندي سؤال. إذ قالت امرأة عمران رب إني نظرت لك ما في بطني محررا فتقبل مني إنك أنت السميع العليم. فلما وضعتها قالت ربي إني وضعتها أنثى والله أعلم بما وضعت وليس الذكر كالأنثى وإني سميتها مريم وإني أعيذها وذريتها من الشيطان الرجيم فتقبلها ربها بقبول حسن وأنبتها نباتا حسنا. طيب الآيات الله سبحانه وتعالى says إذ قالت امرأة عمران, the wife of Imran says ربي إني نظرت لك ما في بطني, I have given this child that is in my stomach, I have offered it to be for your service, it's for you, it's for the Baytullah, محررًا, it's sincerely, freely, all this time is to dedicate it, and this is what they do in Bani Israel, the children of Israel, they used to dedicate their children للعبادة وخدمة دين الله وخدمة بيت الله, they used to dedicate their children for the deen, but it had to be a male, and he didn't do that for the, with the woman. So she gave birth to a girl. She wanted a boy, she gave birth to a girl. But eventually, this woman was Maryam that she gave birth to, and Maryam gave birth to who? Isa ibn Maryam. فأشاهد من هذا لا بد من يحب أن يهب نفسه لله أنا لله خلاص أنا أخذ حقي من الدنيا الذي تيسر ولكن أنا لله أو ابني هذا هو لله يعني كلهم بعضهم للدنيا ولكن لمن هو لله لهذا الدين نحن نحتاج رجال not part time رجال not part time full time هذا صدق who's willing to take their life is for Allah. I have to eat. I have to take care of my family. I get what I can get. But, one of my children, this one here is for Allah. This one here is, I'm going to take care of my life. So it's a wujuk. So it's a kinuk. And lillah. I'm going to feed you. I'm going to clothe you. I'm going to marry you off. But you're dedicated. You have to serve Allah. If you don't do it, who's going to do it? ننتظر المهدي. Are we waiting for the Mahdi to come? ممكن هو سيأتي بعصاه ويسوق الناس. لا بد أن يكون عندنا هكذا. ففي بعض المناطق في اليمن ما شاء الله من منطقة واحدة يخرج عشرات إلى مراكز علم. The youth from one area in Yemen, it would be like maybe 15 of them. They all go to the markaz. They might be miles away, but they're all from that one area. And they come back and they all learn. They come back 15 strong, 20 strong. All of them memorize Quran and then they come back with ilm, knowledge. It's not one person, 15, 12. خير كثير. لأن عندنا مساجد. We have masjids that have no classes. صبر. Masjid. ما في دروس. I mean, هذا سهل عندكم. Is that easy? يعني كأن المساجد تبنى في بعض المناطق كأنه متحف. Like the museum, like the House of Allah's museum. نحن نريد مواصير كذا. We want this type of tiles, have the block. We want this kind of block. مواصير كذا. We want this type of slack, the type of lighting that we want. We want the windows. It has to be the window that's like that. You know? طيب, who's going to be teaching in the masjid? يعني من أغفل الناس المتبرئون المتصدقون from the greatest of people that are not aware that want the biggest rewards but probably don't get it are the ones that take their money and they build masjids. Could you imagine building a masjid for Allah? And when you build a masjid, يقام فيها بدع وشركيات. Like a wizard or like an ajr, my friend. أنت كنت تريد أجر؟ نعم. Imagine somebody build a masjid. And then when the masjid is built, in his shirk, in his bid'ah, في محاربة السنة, come in masjid بنيت على غير تقوى من أول يوم. How many masjids have been built and other than aid in the religion of Allah from the first day? يقام فيها بدعة. This person didn't build this masjid except that he wants the ajr. That's why he built the masjid to get the reward. It's the biggest of rewards. من يتنافس معه. Who can compete with him? نعم. فقد رأيت سبحان الله أناس كان في دمون ونحن في ترين في حضر الموت هناك منطقة يسمى دمون امرأة تنزانية من تنزانيا بنت مسجدا بنى فوقه بيتا وعين من يكون الإمام وركز له وجهز له راتب يا سبحان الله من ذكية نعم. This woman, she built a masjid in Tarim, in Damun, Masjid al-Fatah. And she made an apartment on the top of the masjid. Na'am. And made sure that there's an imam from Ahl al-Sunnah there also. And put some money on the side for him just to have to eat and be taken care of. Now this masjid, mashallah, fiha, yuqam fiha khair. Na'am. So this is how we la but nufakir fi hada. Man say yufakir fi ahl al Hamtramck. Man say yufakir fi him. Antum ahl al Hamtramck. Wa ashab Detroit. Man say yufakir fi him. Wa ashab kada. And ba'dhum qad iktafaw bil ajdran wa saqaf. Some of them they just satisfied with the walls. They see the walls and the floor. Okay, this is a masjid. We have a masjid. That's enough. Walakin ma yakfi. الله صلى الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعيننا في هذا الأمر نحن في عمدة الأحكام وصلنا إلى حديث الرابع قال المؤلف أبو محمد عبد الغني رحمه الله تعالى الحديث الرابع عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا توضع أحدكم فليجعل في أنفه ماء ولينثر ثم لينثر ومن استجمر فليوتر وإذا استيقظ أحدكم من نومه فليغسل يديه قبل أن يدخلهما في الإناء ثلاث فإن أحدكم لا يدري أين باتت يده وفي لفظ لمسلم فليستنشق بمنخريه من الماء وفي لفظ ومن توضأ فليستنشق. In this hadith Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if one of you makes wudu, then put water in his nose and then expel the water from his nose. And if one of you relieves himself and cleans himself with stones, then use an odd number of stones. And if one of you wakes up from his sleep, then wash his hand three times before he puts it in the pail of water. Well, he doesn't know where his hands spent the night. In another narration from Muslim, he says, فَلْيَسْتَنْشِقْ إِسْتِنْشَاقْ هُوَ أَخْذِ الْمَا فِي مَنْخَيْهِ. And he to sniff up the water. In another narration, it says, whoever makes wudu, فَلْيَسْتَنْشِقْ. Whoever makes wudu, then take the water in your nose. So these are hadith to show that it's wajib al-istinthar wal-istinshaq wal-madmada. هذا الذي هو يريد. فجاء في أحاديث كثيرة كما قرأنا. نعم. They're alfaz, they have different wordings. نعم. But the shahid from هذا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا كُنْتُمْ إِلَى صَلَاةِ فَغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ. That's the first thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands. And this is part of washing your face. وَالصُنَّةُ تُبَيِّنُوا الْقُرْآنِ. The sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, that's what he came for. He explains this in the Qur'an. نعم. So from washing your face is these detailed issues. Al-istinshaq. نعم. وجاء أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أنه أفرغ من الإناء على يديه فغسلهما ثم مضمض واستنشق من كف واحد يفعل ذلك ثلاثا. The Prophet used to do the مضمض والاستنشاق من كف واحد. And he didn't separate, do his mouth and then do his nose, but he did it with one time. هذا مفهوم يا إخوة. هذا مفهوم يا عمار. من كف واحد. With one غرفة. يسمى غرفة. غرفة. نعم غرفة جزاك الله خير. And ma, you put it in your hand, you take some of it in your nose and in your mouth at the same time. So what if somebody can't do that? Is it permissible to take some in your mouth and then take another thing and put it up in your nose? Because you can't do it at the same time. I'm la haraj. If somebody can't do it, la haraj.
I had a hard time in the bag.
No. So at the, especially a new Muslim, you may have a difficult time doing that. Nah. But he keeps trying. Nah. The main thing that he does his mouth and that he does his and he does his nose. What's done? You somehow have it istinsha, akhdh al-ma, taking the ma up in your nose. This is istinshaq. Nah. Wa ikhrajuhu, and releasing it is what? Istinthar. Nah. Releasing it is istinthar. In a hadith by Laqit ibn Sabira, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بَالِقْ فِي الْإِسْتِنْشَاقِ إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ صَائِمًا. Exaggerate, you know, sniff up the water in your nose with force. بَالِقْ, do it hard. نعم. Take it up strongly. نعم. بقوة. نعم. إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ صَائِمًا حَتَّى مَا يَصِلِ إِلَى الْجَوْفِ. نعم. Except that if you're fasting, don't do it strongly. نعم. وكل هذا من ماذا؟ من آداب الوضوء والطهارة. كل هذا من آداب الوضوء والطهارة. مقبل نغفل عنه. فنبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يعلمنا كيف نعبد ربنا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he teaches us how to worship Allah in a manner that's pleasing to Allah. In a manner that's pleasing to Allah. نعم. So this is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do the mother will istinshaq with his right hand and release it with his left hand. But can kull hada sunnah. If you did it with the other hand or you did it, the wudu is accepted. The wudu is accepted. And it's important to know that which is wajib, that which is mustahab, na'am, and that which is a rukn in salah, and that which is wajib in the salah. So if you see that you left out something, or somebody else left out something, anta tahkum bis-sawab, you can give the right judgment. Tayyib, putting your right hand over your left hand in the salah, is this wajib? Is it mustahab? Is it rukn? Mother taqulun, putting your right hand over the left hand in the salah while you're standing. Rukn means that if you leave it off, I mean, the salah is batil. You have to do. It's like standing. It's like rukur. Yeah. If it's wajib, that means you have to make sujud al-sahur yajbir. Yeah. Mustahab. Yeah. Right. Meaning it's sunnah. You're going to get reward for doing it. Al-anbiya kulluhum kanu yaf'alun hadha. All the prophets, they used to put their right hand over the left hand. It's mustahab. What does that mean as a mustahab? If you see somebody praying on that with their hands down, nah, is this correct? No. That's not correct. Did the Prophet pray with his hands down? No. Tell you. Ash-shahid, if somebody's praying with their hands down, how the batalat salatu? Could you come to advise them and say, your salah is not accepted?
No.
Why? You're not going to say that. So you have to know, why is this salah accepted? Because this is mustahab. So you're not going to come advising and being harsh, like he did something that's extra aleem, where his salah is not accepted. No, his salah is still accepted. Now, هذا موضع اختلاف. هذا موضع اختلاف. وفي حديث أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وضع يده اليمنى على يده اليسرى على صدره واللفظ على صدره ما صح ما ثابت هذا اللفظ. Now the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم put his right hand over his left hand over his chest. This word على صدره, this word over his chest is not ثابت, is not authentic in that sahih. It's an extra part of the hadith. But when you look at all the other narrations of the hadith, that the Prophet, his hands just wasn't on his other hand, sometimes kind of ala side. So when you see the people that put their hands down here, their hands doesn't reach the side. So So when you have your hand, the Prophet qabad sometimes, and sometimes wada, sometimes you just put it on, sometimes you grab. If you're going to grab this, then it's going to be somewhere in the middle. Exactly where it is, that's not. You know, everybody does what, you know, he tries to do tabiq sunnah. He tries to implement the sunnah according to what he hears from the hadith of the Messenger of Allah. For the dhalika, some people when they see this hadith that is on the side, some people they put it all the way up here on their chest up here. This is not correct. You put your hand all the way up here. Chest. The chest just means, it just means in the front. All this is sadr. But if somebody puts their hands down here, the salah is correct. But it's aqrab to be up more because where you be able to hold on to your forearm. Or put your hand on top of your forearm. The Prophet did both. He just put his hand on top of it, and sometimes he grabbed. So you do that and do that. Sometimes. And this hadith also is min ahkam qada al hajah. How to relieve yourself in the hamam. وهذه النعمة هذه النعمة كان صحابي اسمه سلمان أظنه فقال له يهوديا نبيكم يعلمكم كل شيء حتى الخرائط نعم so your prophet he teaches you everything even how to move your bowel even how to use the bathroom قال نعم ومساق الحديث علمنا رسول الله أمرنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أن لا نستقبل القبلة نستدبرها بالغائط أو بور ولا نستنجي بأقل من ثلاثة أحجار يعني افتخر بهذا الشيء so yes the prophet taught us don't face toward the Qibla or put your back toward the Qibla when you're leaving yourself and he taught us don't do this he taught us don't do that نعمة فهذا العشاء يحتاج الأب يعلم ماذا ابنه والأم تعلم ابنتها نعم هذه العشاء المسلم الجديد قد يغفل عنه so it needs somebody to teach him these things listen you would be surprised and I كنت في نيويورك you'd be surprised how many people go in the bathroom and urinate standing up and just leave Urine all over the place. No water, no nothing, no istinja. Ya subhanallah. Ma ashbah bil haywanat. Allah akramana. Qalat Aisha radiallahu anha. Man akhbarukum. Anna Nasrullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bala qa'iman fa huwa kadhab. Hada bihasib dhanniha. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, whoever tells you that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam urinated while he was standing up, and he's a liar. This is ala hasib dhanniha. This is according to what she knows. She's the Prophet's wife. And this is something the Prophet normally did, that he would sit down when he's urinating. Teach your children to sit down when they urinate. Don't stand up urinating. But Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu qala ra'aytu rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yabulu qa'iman fi sibatati qawm. I saw the Prophet standing, urinating in the garbage area of a people. So it's permissible if what? If their urine does not splash back on you. But if you go to the toilet and you urinate in that water is going to splash back, right? It's hitting. While your urine is hitting that water, it's going to splash back on your clothes. The Prophet said, wait a little, aqab. This water didn't touch it. What if urine is on you? And you pray. فَمَرُّ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ كَمَا جَاءَ فِي الصَّحِيمِ مِنْ حَدِيثِ ابن عباس بِقَبَرَيْنِ The Prophet passed by two graves. فَقَالَ إِنَّهُمَا لَيُعَذَّبَانِ He said, these two are being punished in their graves. أَحَدُهُمَا كَانَ يَمْشِي بِالنَّمِيمَةِ One of them used to speak bad about people and slander and do namima. But then, كَانَ لَا يَسْتَنْزِهُ مِنَ الْبَوْلِ The other one being punished in his grave because he didn't make sure that urine didn't come on him when he relieved himself. Ya subhanAllah, min deen. Min tanbih. The Prophet is talking, telling his sahabas about the hal of somebody that's dead in his grave. Man al-fatan, man yatafatan. Who's going to be aware and be like, listen, I don't want any urine on my clothes when I'm offering worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, you're supposed to ask how many go in the masjid and they just urine and stand it up. The water splashing about, they leave urine on the seat. Yeah, subhanAllah. Like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us qada al-haja, because there's a heavy connection between qada al-haja and tahara. Na'am. There's a heavy connection, So you have to clean yourself correctly. Na'am. So when a new Muslim comes into Islam, somebody has to take him on the side and say, listen, when you go to the bathroom, you have to start cleaning yourself now. Astaghfirullah. I shouldn't say start cleaning yourself now. I'm not saying that the disbelievers don't clean themselves, but you have to teach them how to make sure they get it done correctly. Now, فالكفار في حماماتهم ما يستعملون الماء داخل الحمام. هذا عادتهم. They don't put water in the cabina, in the area of the hamam. So if you travel in Bilad al-Islam, if you went from Yemen, you went to Abu Dhabi, or you went to Emirat, or you went to anywhere in the Arab world, when you go to the hamamat, when you go to the bathroom at the airport and you go inside, it's going to be running water. If you was in Oman, if you was in Bahrain, if you was in Kuwait, as soon as you leave that area, you touch down in Greece somewhere, or some London somewhere, or France somewhere, anywhere outside. But you're Muslim, you're awful, you're just used to that every day. So you go to the bathroom, you put your travel bag down, and there's no water. Sometimes there's no paper. You have to go back outside, you have to take out this paper, you have to wet up all this paper, you got to get water, you got to get your bottle. The people are looking at you like, well, you cleaning the bathroom? No. I was in Yemen for 19 years before I came back. And I stopped here in Abu Dhabi, or I stopped here, then I went to Greece. And I needed the bathroom. When I entered the bathroom, they have these hamamats, they have these stalls that's on the wall. One guy was on the wall urinating. The other guy was in the stall urinating. They had their backs to him, and they were talking. What are you going to do after that? What are you going to know? What are you going to eat? I'm through. I'm finished. I just made my first touchdown. My first time. I just got in Greece, the first land outside of the land of Muslims. They're urinating in two different directions, talking to each other about lunch. Good, yeah, wait. Na'am. فَعَلَّمَنَا نَبِيُّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ خَيْرٍ. The Prophet taught us these important things. So, maybe it needs to be written down. Na'am, who can go through Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim and Abu Dawood and At-Tirmidhi and Nisa'i and Ibn Majah? And gather up all the things that have to do with cleaning yourself in the bathroom. Put it down all on the paper. Organize it. Check it with somebody. And hand it out to the Muslims. Man, how many Muslims don't know these things? So it doesn't take like somebody, Imam, just text you. Just open up that book. Look at the chapters of relieving yourself. It's right there. It's going to be in the first chapters of the book. Go in that book, write it down. Now we have computers these days. You can just look it right up there, get them all, organize it. You can name a chapter. How to wash your hands. You can name the chapter. You're the sheikh. Ma'in, you're the sheikh. How to wipe yourself. How many times to wipe yourself. Then you could try to make it suitable for today. Na'am. Like today, when you go to the bathroom, you have to like clean the toilet before you use it. So it's good to have these baby wipes. Tarifun the baby wipes. Ya Muhammad, Tarifun the baby wipes. Yeah. هذا الفان الذي هم بلل هذا ضروري ضروري لا تجد نفسك بدون هذا وأنت مسافر حلقت تحنت. نعم. When you go in the bathroom, there's urine on the seat. On the back of the seat, where you put your back, in tebe min hadha, malian ba. So you have to spend 5 minutes just preparing the bathroom, just to use the bathroom. Don't let your garment and your pants fall on the floor. Nah, you have to be, yeah, I mean, ready to go in the bathroom. You have to wash the floor. Na'am ya Khalil. Kaifa? You have to dabbir nafsak. You have to get some water. You have to get some fine. Na'am. It's good to have a little bit on you all the time. A little fine or something. Al-ma laysa wajib. Water is not wajib. Na'am. You can use fine. You can use cloth. Na'am. You might find yourself fi haji. You might have to use al-hajar. Can the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yastajmirun. That's what comes in this hadith. Na'am. But the water is better, Khalil. Water is better. Na'am. You have water. That's good. Na'am. So a child has to be aware of that when he goes to the bathroom. Your son in his coat pocket, he should have some tissue. He should have some tissue, have some napkin. Sometimes he might sneeze. Sometimes his nose might be running. Na'am. You don't want your son or your daughter to be going, when that wind's blowing, the body automatically starts working, starts heating up. So the nose to seal, this automatically comes down, He needs a little fine to go there. If he has to go to the bathroom, he needs to know how to clean himself, how to conduct himself. Na'am. هذا مما يهمنا في هذا الحديث. نعم.
Now, like, what if you go into a, like a public restroom and it's just nasty? You can't just stand up instead of.
والله يعني واحد يدبر نفسه. It's permissible to stand up when you urinate, but you have to make sure that the urine doesn't come back on you. نعم. So. So you have to be aware before you go. It's good to even carry a dump of water if you can, if you know. Naam, masaha. Naam. And ahadahu. هذه الأمور إخوة يا مهم. هذه الأمور مهمة. هذا درسنا اليوم باقي لنا دقائق. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعيننا جميعا في هذه الأمور. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. هذا سؤال طيب يا خليل. هذا بطل. الذي يسأل سؤال بطل صراحة. شجاع. الذي يسأل سؤال شجاع. نعم. لا ينال العلم المستحيي والمستكبر. The ones that shy, he's like, no, they might laugh at me. He's not gonna get any knowledge. He's not gonna get any knowledge. No. فالحياء لا مجال لها في نيل العلم. لا مجال لها. You know, that you're too embarrassed to ask a question. No, you have to ask. Come up and raise your hand. And say, no, I didn't understand. No, I disagree. No, I didn't get it. And just from you asking, other people is going to benefit. الحمد لله سبحان الله. نعم.
عندي سؤال بس خارج الموضوع.
تفضل.
سألني أحد أصدقائي في العمل لماذا